I am excited about today. If Tom has put together an antique centre, it's going to be good.
The Swan Inn, for centuries a coaching stop on the main London to Oxford Road, is an award-winning antique centre. After 30 years in the trade, veteran auctioneer Tom Keane is using his passion, expertise and encyclopedic knowledge to bring together some of the best dealers in the trade and make sure there's a first-class range of antiques displayed here.
I just love the business. I love the history behind the piece of furniture, the antiques. We still learn every day. You still see things you haven't seen all the time, and it's not an exact science. An idiot like me can get away with it. Hello, Drew.
Hello, mate. How are you?
How are you?
Nice to meet you.
Well, welcome to Oxford's best kept secret.
So you'll have to give us the tour then, because I've not been here before.
I'll show you all around.
Yeah, can we have a look?
Come on.
Tom leads the way around the sprawling building, where 40 rooms showcase the offerings of the 80 different dealers.
So these are all different dealers, yeah?
All different dealers. You've got Chloe and David in there, and Chris in there, the rug man. These dealers all come and maintain their rooms every week, and they all do well out of it.
Look at that. That's a really good room, isn't it?
Oh, yeah.
That's how to do it if you want to retail. That looks great, yeah.
And it smells nice in here too, doesn't it?
It does, yeah. It does, doesn't it?
It does.
Going through the building, there's obviously lots of different rooms, lots of different dealers with their own take and their own look and their own style. Walk into this room, they've got a great style. I really like it. And they've got a couple of really nice things in here as well. Oh, that's a stonking one. Look at that.
Yes, that was shot locally. You see the bullet wound to the right-hand side.
Did it get the bullet wound since it's been in here or what?
Yeah. No, that was the actual fatal wound, and we ate the rest of it.
That's nice. Yeah, I like that a lot. Great look. That is just an absolute belter. It really is. Just the size and shape of the horn. They usually come out a lot flatter and wider, and this one's raised right up and they're curling over and back in. It's almost like a skull framed by a horned love heart, you know. It's really got it all going on. Then it's got a brilliant thing. It's got a great big bullet hole right through the head, which is so gruesome. But thinking about sales-wise, it really adds to it.
The unmounted water buffalo skull and horns dates from the 19th century. Its battered look reflects its age, which adds to its sculptural appeal. And it could be worth around £600.
So you got £575 on it, so what are you doing? What can you do?
£575, we'd do it for you. No bibby, £500.
I am gonna bid you.
I knew you would.
I can't help it, it's in my nature. I was really happy at £450 and I'd take it, yeah.
So at £475 you can, but at £450 you can't.
Just can't. I'll have it.
There you are. There you are. I'm going to pull it out of the head for you. Yeah.
That one's exceptional. So I'll pay up for that because it's exactly what we're looking for, all rolled into one. And when you put something in front of you that is the best, you've got to buy it. And that one's the best one I've seen.
One great buy in the bag, and Drew's only just started.
It's a big place, isn't it?
It is, yeah. How many steps? Is your step count up to?
It is. Yeah. Not bad, actually, today. I think we're in about 4,000.
That. Little drinks trolley.
Mm-hmm.
Lovely. Different. Great colour. Just odd. Look at his face now.
I've never seen you buy anything vaguely like that.
I haven't bought anything like this before.
Well, it was the first time for everything.
It's just cutesy cool. It's just got a certain look to it, and I think it's really well priced. Cutesy cool little sort of malachite green almost drinks trolley. Late 1940s thing. Really just cute. It's completely untouched and it's got the glass top, which is meant to be green glass, but that's expensive. So what they've done is they've got clear glass and glued green paper underneath it nicely. So it's sort of been really done to a price. So it's sort of, it's meant to look really grand, but it really isn't.
The two-level raffia-covered drinks trolley with its striking circular design and bold colour probably dates from the 1940s and could be worth around £300.
What can you do that for? 150?
150, 150, 150. I can't do a lot.
I know. That's all right.
130, and don't beard me because I can't. There you are.
Sold.
All right.
Thank you very much. That's nice too. You can bring me my breakfast with this in the morning.
Can you fill it with drinks and then we'll take it away?
Oh yeah.
We might still be there in the morning.
Yeah.
No, it's give you a room too.
I think all of next year for me will all be about colour. I think that's just stuck with me now. It's something that I want in my life. I want it in my own home. So I just transfer that into my business and what I'm selling. Ah, okay.
Another room full of interesting bits.
Interesting bits and bobs.
This is what I love about antique centres, because it's just a totally different look again. It's a different take. Can this be 180 quid?
How much is it?
225.
225. It can be 190.
Let's get it out and have a better look at it.
The Moroccan-style mahogany side table, with its carved detailing and two tiers, dates from the early 20th century and could be worth around £350.
It is a bit of a little classic English country house look to it. It really is. Imagine that next to a wonderful armchair with a big old table lamp on it, piled up with books and gin. It's just got that feel about it, and it's not a lot of money. So what do we agree? 180 if it's all right?
190 it was, wasn't it?
Yeah, 180 is good, though, isn't it?
But 190 is better. I'll do something better for you as we go around.
I know. Paid 190 for it. There's a very, very tight profit in this one after the work. I think there's probably 40 quid worth of work on it as well. We're going to be 230 to 240 into it, and I'm not going to get £300 for it. So there's 50, 60 quid profit left in that. Not great, but a profit's a profit, and it's another bit of stock. The girls are screaming at me for stock. They want as much as they can get their hands on. So I'll just keep buying.
The Swan is certainly turning out to be a banker. It's got just the type of quirky, eye-catching, elegant pieces that Drew's after. And there's more outdoors.
About five or six different people own this side of things.
Yeah.
So
they're good, aren't they?
Yeah, they're marble.
They're modern, are they?
They're a little bit of age, but I thought I might be a bit older.
Yeah. Good, though, aren't they? Mm. We've come outside to the architectural bit they've got in the yard here. And the first thing I see, and I can't take my eyes off them, is a pair of marble goats, and they're carved from a single piece of marble each. They're not that old, 30, 40 years old, but they look like something from the 70s. They've got that sort of Hollywood, chic-y, glamour look to them, and they're actually really well done.
The two goats, carved out of white marble and dating from the mid-20th century, could be worth around £1,500.
What are they, for the two of those, £225 each, £450 for the two.
450 quid.
For two, cheap.
Stylized mountain goats.
Didn't you say you were scared of these?
Goats?
Yeah, you said really, really scared. Oh, ghosts.
Well, they don't exist. And how much? 450?
450.
The pair?
The pair.
Sold.
On the van.
There you
On the van. Love them. Great. Really interesting. Where I see those is in a house. They're made to be in a house. They just look brilliant. Hopefully one of the better decorators will get their hands on them and they'll go through there. Just super stylish. They're sort of brutalist into Art Deco, and they're a real weird mix, but yeah, love them.
As predicted, the Antique Centre has turned out to be a top-notch banker. Drew knew that with Tom at the helm, it would have just the type of quirky, quality, off-the-wall pieces that he needs for his business. And the Swan has certainly paid off.
Today, really good. Dealing with Tom, straightforward. He's been in the trade forever. The bison skull that I bought was the best example I've seen. That one just had that extra 1%. You know, it's got the X factor. It's bigger. It's a better shape. It's a better colour. It's got the big, massive bullet hole through the head. A real fun purchase today was the little green drinks trolley, because it's perfect. It's a great colour, that real malachite-y green colour they've got there. So saleable, and somebody's going to have a real fun, kitschy, cool little thing in their house. Buy of the day was the pair of marble goats. They are exceptional in their form. The carving on them, I would say, is like a 9 out of 10. They're very brutalist into sort of deco, into sort of modernism. They're a real weird style. Just great, and at the price, 450 quid. I see them all day long at £1,200 to £1,500, and they're worth it.
Well, Drew's got an eagle eye. He walked straight into room 28 here and spotted a bison head, and his body language told me straight away he wanted it. Listen, he's bought it. Hope he does well out of it.